So spring has sprung, and because of that, we know that snakes have been in hibernation for a period of time, probably 3 to 4 months with the colder weather. They haven't been eating, and they're actually going to come out and be much more active at this time as our weather warms up. You'll notice that they're going to be in the woods, across paths, on the roads. They're going to be sunbathing, trying to absorb as much heat as possible so they can get their energy and go find their meal. Now, they're not out to get us. They're just looking to survive. And they do have a very important purpose in our environment, in our habitats, and they assist with us as well. For example, the rat snakes and corn snakes that we commonly come across, our king snakes, are excellent. Those guys, they're helping with our rodent populations, they're helping keep disease down. Our king snakes can eat other snakes, which is why they're one of our best friends, if you want to look at it that way. So there are approximately 50 different species of snakes in Alabama. However, probably the most common ones that we're going to run across are going to be like your rat snake, your corn snake, there's black racer. Those are probably the most common that you'll see. Now on your venomous side, you're going to come across your timber rattlesnake and your copperhead and your cottonmouth. Those are the most common venomous that you'll come across. Now, the copperhead are the most secretive, you could say. You generally don't see them until you're on them, and that's when they're typically going to bite, is because you've startled them, you've scared them. Their reaction to us interacting with them is they want to stay calm and quiet and stay as secretive as possible so that we don't see them and they can stay hidden and move on with their lives, if you will. They tend to just sit and ambush their prey at that moment. But again, if we come across and step on them, unlike a rattlesnake, they don't have anything they can warn us with, and that's when we get bitten. Snakes don't have ears, so they can't necessarily hear us, but they can feel our vibrations, they can feel our movements. So when we're walking through the woods on trails, even just anywhere with high grasses that aren't regularly maintained, do be aware of your footing and what is around you, your surroundings at all times. Walk with a heavy foot. Just kind of make yourself known as you're moving, and that way they'll kind of sense it. If you come across a log in your path, one thing I suggest is you step on it and then over it, not just directly over it. And that is making yourself known. You're stepping on the log. If there is a critter inside there, if there's a snake inside, it tells them, hey, there's something out there, and they're either going to go at one end or the other, or they're just going to bunker down and wait for you to leave. But it tells them, hey, there's a predator on top. When it comes to identifying a venomous versus non-venomous snake, of course, the biggest indicator is their head. If we want to look at this corn snake here, she has what we call a thumb-shaped head, right? So it's very smooth. Her neck is not much thinner than her face. It's kind of a very straightforward approach. Looks very much like the shape of my thumb. We know that's a positive head shape. If she were venomous, she would have a very much triangular shape. It would come out on the ends here for pit vipers. Now, not every venomous snake has the triangular shaped head. In Alabama, we have 6 venomous snakes, and 5 out of the 6 do have that triangular shaped head. They are pit vipers. The only exception is our eastern coral snake, and those are the ones with the bright colored bands, red, yellow, and black. They're actually very rare at this point, and they're found much further south in Alabama.